In this video, we are going to use MQL5 to create an expert advisor that is going to do a sell trailing stop based on the Bollinger Bands. So let's see how we can do that with MQL5.
In this video, we are going to create an expert advisor that uses Bollinger Bands to manage trades. Let's see how we can do that. We start by opening Metaeditor, which can be done by clicking the icon or pressing F4. The code begins by including the trade library, which provides trading functions. We then create an instance of CTrade, named Trade, to handle our trading operations. The OnTick function is where the main logic of our expert advisor resides. We declare a static variable named LastStopBollingerBandsValue to store the last value of the Bollinger Band's stop level. We calculate the ask price using the SymbolInfoDouble function with the symbol ask parameter and normalize it to the correct number of digits. Similarly, we calculate the bid price using the symbol bid parameter. If there are no open positions, indicated by PositionsTotal being less than 1, we execute a sell order of 0.1 sen lots, which is equivalent to 10 micro lots. The sell order is placed at the bid price, with a take profit set 150 points below the bid price. After placing the sell order, we reset the last stop Bollinger Band's value to a high value 1000 to ensure proper trailing stop logic. Next, we create two arrays, upper band array and lower band array, to store the Bollinger Band's values. We set these arrays to be sorted from the current candle downwards using array set as series. We define the Bollinger Bands using the IBANDS function with a period of 20, no shift, and a deviation of 2 based on the closing price. We copy the Bollinger Bands data into our arrays using copy buffer. The upper band values are copied into upper band array and the lower band values into lower band array. We then calculate the last upper and lower band values from these arrays. The logic checks if the last upper band value is above the ask price and if it is lower than the last stop Bollinger Bands value. If both conditions are met, we call the check Bollinger sell trailing stop function with the last upper band value and update last stop Bollinger Bands value for the next function call. The check Bollinger sell trailing stop function iterates through all open positions. For each position, it retrieves the symbol and checks if it matches the current symbol. If it does, it gets the position ticket and the current stop loss. If the current stop loss is above the last upper band value or is not set, the stop loss is moved to the last upper band value using the position modify function. Once we have finished writing the code, we press F7 to compile it. If this was too fast for you, or if you don't understand what all the code is doing, you may want to check out the premium course on our website or watch one of the basic videos first. If everything works, we go back to MetaTrader by pressing F4 or clicking on the icon. Back in MetaTrader, we press Ctrl and R to start the strategy tester. We select the expert advisor that we have just created, enable visual mode, and start a strategy test. We should then see the expert advisor on the chart. If you are already a premium course member and have an idea for a video like this one, feel free to send us an email. In this video, we have learned how to create an expert advisor that uses Bollinger Bands for trailing stop management with a few lines of MQL code. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.
Okay, I hope that your Bollinger Bands sell trailing stop is working as expected. In the case that this was too fast for you, or if you have no idea what all the code is doing, maybe the premium course might be interesting for you. You can find that one on our website. For now, I say thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video.